Hi, it was a good drive and
good evening.
Everybody's in cars today.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How about you?
I'm well, thank you. Are you driving?
Well, no, I'm sitting in a parking lot. I'm in the car and I just got here.
Okay, so you will drive by us.
I was driving 2 minutes ago, yes.
Okay. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you leading us?
Well, wait a minute. It seems that my wife is sitting in the car to the traffic people been coming around, so even if it's sitting in the car, they're not gonna have it. Okay, thank you. Yep.
Live in peace.
So I think for today, as it is the first event of the booklet reflections, we are going, first of all, before talking about the booklet for April, I would like to tell you, we finally published the booklet for December Light. It is on Facebook. You have received the three links in three different languages for the booklet Light December as a notification to your emails. I wish you can check this out. And you can download it, you can print it and compare the three versions from French to English to Spanish. And I promise next time we are working with our editor and with our translator for the version in Arabic to be ready for the next booklets. So for now we have three languages and we are looking forward to have it in the fourth language. I also want to ask you if there is another language that is not yet, the booklet is not yet produced in it, you can also get in touch with us and we will see if we can do it in the language you request. It will be a pleasure. You can also request, or you can also become an editor contributor or writer contributor. You just need to contact me or Rosemary on the email that is on the last page of the booklet, as we have posted it on Facebook. Have a look, Facebook page or LinkedIn page or Instagram page, all in whichever one you prefer, they are there. For those who cannot write in English and only in their language, no problem. We invite you to write as long as you have joy and you like writing. We are going to do the translation and the editing for your poems or paragraphs or essays or whatever. We are happy, actually very happy, because we've been working on that and trying to get the best version of it. It's not easy, but finally we could publish it and we are so happy to do that. You can go and read a couple of essays on our Facebook page that are being posted one day. I think every day we are posting one or two essays. And this meeting is the first event for the writing workshop. We are going along with Rosemary to tell you the topic, and Rosemary is going to guide us and guide you through what we are going to write and what we are going to write about. And then we are going to show you, I have actually printed the booklet, so I'm going to show you the printed version, and you can also print it. Yes, I have printed the booklet in two or three versions. I'm going to show you. It's so, so cute, little. I can put it in my pocket wherever I go. It's light, it's not heavy. And when I'm in the tramway or in the metro, I can read. And myself, sometimes I need to see the connotation of a word in a different language. So I see the Spanish version from the Spanish version to the English or to the French, because I'm working on my Spanish and it's helping a lot, I guess. And I envision it will help you as well in your journey of learning English. Sayed, I'm so happy to see you. It's been a long time. How are you doing?
Hi, Sayed.
How are you?
Okay.
How are you, Arifan? Yeah, hello to everyone.
And that's my hope again to see you all, and especially you, teacher, and also Dr. Rosemary. I think you wanna go somewhere.
Go somewhere?
I think Diana has been taking exams.
Dr. Rosemary, I had one exam, data structure.
Great.
In my computer science. It was so difficult, but I got prepared more, preparation more, and everything is done.
Oh, I am happy to hear good news. Yes. Good news.
Yes. Yes.
And one exam was faster. It's about the math exam. I took 88 from 100.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great.
Yes, 80 out of 100. That's great. That's
good. Yeah. Yes.
Everything is going on well. And I'm so happy about my exams. The results is good. And I'm so happy to take preparation for my exams. And tonight I decided with myself the class is tomorrow is the off day, because in Islamic countries we have to catch the fast tomorrow.
Yes.
In all Islamic countries, tomorrow is off day.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Well, I hope it's going to be a month of connection, a month of spirituality, enough of a month of good deeds, a month of mindfulness, and of good things. Yes, I know. I know in my country also some people do that, though Turkey is kind of a very... So it is said that it's like Muslim country, but some people do, some people don't, you know. Mm. But anyway, it's announced too.
Afghanistan is a different country. 100 people are Muslims, 100% people are Muslims. That's one thing. And all people catch the fast. And one thing more, it's difficult weather in hard weather, and we catch fast for 14 hours in a day.
Wow.
Good night.
No eating, no drinking, no use abuse language or bad language in society, and we can't argue with other people. Everything is banned.
Wow.
Yes, well, yeah. I hope that it's like, I don't know, but for me, you sometimes the soul, and sometimes we need just to use it or think of it as an opportunity to go back to those good habits, to those good things, yeah, which we need to do on a daily basis. So it is a holy month, but after this month, we should continue the good habits we've been doing during the month. So this is the most important. And yes.
Although not eating or drinking for 14 hours is a pretty big deal.
Yeah, it's difficult. It is difficult for 10 people, for example, like me. But that's a good news for those people. They are so fat and they have a lot of fatty. Yeah. And they can lose our weight in this 1 month. I think there's a good news for patients and for those people, they want to lose the weight.
I have never seen it this way, but it's funny. It's funny to see it this way. Okay.
That can be a new beginning.
Yeah. Yeah. while you were talking, Sayed, I had a moment to grab the book, the printed booklet, which I want to show all of you. So here it is. It's as small as that. Do you see, like seven by five?
Ten.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And very light. The pages are very light. You can see here the table of content. This one. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Wow.
Yes, and very, this was printed in English, and there is another one in French, and you can also print it in Spanish. I sent you three links to your emails, and hopefully we can also send you the Arabic next time. And yeah, I'd like to invite... Oh, hi, Nancy, you're in the car.
Yeah.
Hi, Nancy.
I'm going to need to turn off and drive.
Yes, okay. Okay, going to catch up later.
I'll be back in 10 minutes or so.
Yes, okay.
Okay, great.
Okay, bye. So guys, I was saying for this month, we need
to take a break.
And think about new beginnings. So I'm going to share my screen and show you the calendar so that sometimes because you attend sessions with guides, you open new ways of writing.
Oh,
I'm going to just mute Rosemary because she is still speaking. So let me share my screen and show you the website.
Yeah.
And show the themes that are being, or the lessons, the sessions for this month. Okay, so here we are. So what we can, or how we can brainstorm is looking at the titles that the guide have been, one of the ways have been writing and meditate. So for example, here, for Rosemary's Wednesday program, it is a metaphysical discussion about abundance. So if you consider abundance as a new beginning, you can also see this as a topic to write about. So Rosemary is making or reading a book entitled Think and Grow Rich. So it's a perception of things, actually. What do you think? Which richness would you like to speak about, or what do you think this richness can be? Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, the writer.
Just, I want to say one thing about this book. I bought this book and I studied it. The good news is this.
This book. So what do you think about it?
Yeah, this one person wrote this book, and this interesting and beautiful books. They collected the rich people ideas, and I think if a person wanna make our mind, and I believe that if a person wanna reach to ourselves, to our targets, their targets, he must buy this book and study. Yeah. Bought this. My friend sent this book from the Kabul province. A huge distance between two provinces. But I tried to find this book, and in the final, I found this book, and I studied. This is amazing in particular books for every person.
Oh, thank you. Well, I personally didn't read it, but I'm following always the sessions of Rosemary on Wednesdays, and I'm catching up on the reading of this book, which I find also very interesting in terms of wholeness and the new beginnings, with joy, with connection to what it is around, with wholeness, with abundance in everything. And you know, this is April. April is considered to be, let's say, the fourth month of the year. So I think that it's time also to think that new day has come, new start has come, but this start should be, and also it is connected to this holy month in Islam, and also recently was the Thanksgiving. So these are events and occasions where we can question ourselves and think a new start, a new beginning, in joy, in wholeness, in connectedness and connection to the world that is around. So thank you, Sayed. I definitely look forward to read this book. I hope I can get the time to do that. Abu, have you heard or have you attended Rosemary's session on Wednesday about Think and Grow Rich?
Yes, I attended this program and I started reading this book, and I find this book is very interesting. And I also start listening to the audiobook.
Okay, good.
For the reading, I am actually in the preface.
In what?
Preface.
Pray fast. Uh-huh. So actually, if you find it as a resource, as a good resource for you to write a paragraph, you can also use this material or this session as you go next week. Maybe it can inspire you to write something about abundance. I will move to the next one. I will move to the session of Osvaldo. Osvaldo also has a very interesting session that he entitled Guidance to New Beginners. So the tips, maybe the tricks, the teaching that we need to provide new beginners with. So let's see. So he said there are situations in the journey of life that requires guidance, especially after a failure adventure. So with him, you are going to have a guidance that is going to keep you ongoing, to keep you reaching and your goals and your adventure. So I don't know if I want to start telling you that it hasn't been one time nor two times. It's been many times, a lot of times I have failed things and started over and over and over. And it's a joy, actually. After you succeed, you are going to look backward and you say, wow, I made it. And it's a great joy to start again, to have confidence enough and strength enough to start after a failure. Have you experienced in the past something such a thing, like when you failed at something, you stand up, you continue it, and you succeeded? How did it feel? Sayed, I think you can tell us more than one story about failure. And I can't hear you. You are mute.
Me?
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Now right I now? Hear. Yes, now
yeah, I hear. Just repeat your question again. I'm sorry.
Yes, I said an experience where we failed and then we stand up again, we stood up again, and we continued, and we succeeded the second or the third time.
Yeah, that's a great question about my life. When I graduated from school, yeah.
Yes.
When I graduated from school, I decided to leave everything.
Yes.
No more studies and no more education. And I decided to get and earn more money and continue my life. And after that, a lot of people, I thought I lost everything. I'm paid more. The cause is I lost my father. And then when I think, if I leave this all things, what will I do in the future time? How I can stop my studies? Then some good people, they gave some suggestions to me. Yeah, you don't stop. You must go more. You can do more. You have a good mind, and you have to solve the problems, and you can do this. You can do this. They give more suggestion. They give more suggestion to me. Then I decided with myself. After 1 year, again I started my studies, and now I believe that I'll never stop my studies, and I'll never stop to any barriers, and I'll never go back. Every time I go forward, and the cause is this, and this time I have a lot of friends, for example, especially like Dr. Rosemary and you and our team members, they support me and they tell me you can do everything. And in this time, the situation of Afghanistan, there's education is not important in Afghanistan. The cause is this, there's a person who has a lot of money and who has a lot of power. That's a good person, and that's that can get more power and can get more state. There is no value for education and no respect for educated people. But I'm struggling, and this time I'm training the girls students, and also I'm training the boys students for bright future. And now there's a good news for me. I have two schools. One is in Helmand province and one is in Kandahar province for open students. And Dr. Rosemary has more information about this. And that's a good news to I support and I teach the open students and without payments and without fee. One time I was nothing, just I think I can't do anything, but right now I like this point. I have two schools. When I teach them, I think there's everything for me.
Yes, thank you. That's a great example. I just want to add something to what you have said. Failures. We all may have failures. I mean, even the greatest or the people who made great success, they failed one day. And success comes from failure also. The most important is to see the experience as it is, to extract. I mean, an experience cannot be all of it failure. Of course, the result is failure, but there should be something that we have learned, something that we have done good. So we are going to evaluate the experience in order to have a new start and a new beginning. And I think that you can also extract from your failure the things that you wanna reconsider, redo in a better way, and we move on. The most important is not to give up and to move on and to think that tomorrow is going to be a new day. Tomorrow is going to be a new start. Thank you, Sayed, for your intervention. I want also, so if you think that this could be a material or a resource for you to write your paragraph or your essay from, keep on attending the class of Oswaldo that is on Friday at 8 a.m. New York time. And I am sure you are going to learn much and you are going to be inspired to write your paragraph based on his teaching. The second or the third program I would like you to have a look at is the 20th of April, that is the program of Lorraine. She's going to teach us the energy or the daily energy for a new beginning. So resetting and refreshing our energy in daily life. Because also, here is her description, I'm going to read it for you. So resetting and refreshing our energy in daily life with heart math techniques. You know, Lorraine has been in a study or a research called heart math techniques. They use this calculation for the hearts to connect and for the world to connect to the heart. So these are tools and they help us open to new beginnings. It may be sometime at some point that we feel locked or we feel stuck, but these tools and this class and this session is going to help us open again and have the motivation and to start again and over. So we can use them to prepare our day and reset our energy during the day. And also it can happen daily. It doesn't mean that it's, I mean, yearly, but in one day we may have up, middle or down energy. It happens. You get up the morning, you are full of energy, you meditate, you say, okay, I'm going to have a great day. But then with the succession of events, you are going to feel down. So she is going to teach you tools and techniques, how to lift up, how to have always great energy and to start again in one day. I mean, from an hour to another, a minute to another, a second to another. Can we speak a little about a day during which our energy was disturbed or changed from positive to negative or from negative to positive? And what can we do when you feel down, for example? What can we do to lift up ourselves? What do you think? What can we do in our day to be always positive and energetic? Yes, sir, just, go ahead.
Just I want to say one thing about this issue. I think the important thing, two things is important. If a person wants to be more active and more good, the first one is that he must be honest with every person.
Okay.
And the second one is he must be a compassionate person. Compassion is important. Compassionate is important in society. And another one is be honor with other people.
Okay, great.
That's very true.
So what in your day, for example, if it happens that you feel a bit down or you feel what are the tools? What do you do usually to lift yourself up, to think that, okay, I can start again. I can, after 1 hour, I can have a positive thought. I should have a positive thought. What are
the things that I'm so happy in my life, I'm extroverts. I talk with everyone. I make my friends laugh. They laugh, and also the important thing that I love, I like this to help other people. Yeah, in every respect. For example, in learning, in problems, solving problems, and also in every respect that I can. And also, I like to be active in every time, in every place. I don't want to waste my time on negative things and negative. I don't want to waste my time with negative friends and bad friends. I like study more. I like to be honest with my friends, and also I like this to help with my friends. That's the way. I'm so happy in my life, and I feel I'll never feel down in my life. I think that's the effective methods that I use, but I'm trying to find more information about this, how I can be more happy. But
okay, I understand. That's great. So this class actually is one of the classes that is going to help you get to understand the tools and the techniques for a new possibility, opportunities daily tools, how to lift up yourself, and how to be positive and to get positive energy for yourself and for people around you. Thank you, Sayed.
Yeah.
Abu, are you here? Abu, are you here? I think Abu, yes, I think he cannot speak. People are around him. Rosemary, I am happy you could join us. Maybe I can ask you to give us a little or general idea on what our members or writers are supposed to write about for the month of April.
I've been listening as I've been driving to your discussion. I think you've done a wonderful job of putting out ideas, ways of thinking.
I've been through the sessions, I thought maybe our members can also go through the sessions. As they learn from the sessions, it can be a material or a resource for them to write their paragraphs. But I am sure you can tell us. I mean, I like the way you do it. It's precise and concise. So, yeah, so help us with that.
Thank you. What I wanted to do, and I don't know if you've got a page to share. Do you have an English page from Anne-Marie?
English page? Yes, I have it. Uh-huh, have it.
Okay, let's look at that, because she does a beautiful job. She's doing the same thing, creating the same kind of booklet. And she does a beautiful job of getting us to imagine everyday kind of experience with her that illustrates, that's an example of what she's saying, of the idea that she's sharing with us. So can you share your screen?
Yes, so this is what Anne-Marie has been writing. She named it Thought of the Day, April 2021. And here are a couple of very interesting thoughts. Yes, you can also, I mean, soon we are going to post this as soon as we can get it in a format that is postable, actually. So here, Rosemary, do you need me to scroll down?
Yes, please scroll down. Mm-hmm. But that's just the introduction.
Mm-hmm. So good morning, word of the day. It's a simple word, as she said, but the meaning behind this word is someone, good morning. It is motivating, right. Actually. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, each time she thinks of something that we can also think of. And it's really simple, down to earth. This, like, I'm going to read this aloud. This is something that we wish for all the people of the world. Do I really know what that little word, good morning, means? It's a way to start the day with a positive attitude, an open attitude toward our surroundings, toward nature, and most importantly, toward ourselves. I look at myself in the mirror and say, good morning, dear known human being, or to be known human being. I start this day with good thoughts. They are present in all my cells, and they spread from me to what is surrounding me. I bless this beautiful day. So what do you say when you look at yourself in the mirror first thing in the morning?
I like it. Yeah.
I mean,
I like it.
Yeah. I'm more likely to say, oh, my hair looks awful, or something like that. You know, not, oh, good morning, beautiful being.
Yes, absolutely.
And it's very simple, and it's amusing, and it makes you think.
Motivating, a good attitude to start the day with.
Yeah, exactly. So let's read another one.
So we
have not this one.
New day. On Easter, we have...
No, not Easter. Okay, may creation bless me.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The rhythm of life. Do I feel that the blessing of creation is always present at every moment of my life? Why don't I feel it, the rhythm of creation? Why don't I feel it when I feel sad? The answer is very simple. The sad moments are moments when my doors for receiving blessings are closed. This means that when I remain in an emotion, in a feeling of sadness or anger, I am in isolation. I observe my breathing. I feel how the breath comes in and out of my nostrils. I rejoice in the calm that begins to surround my whole being, and it is now that the blessing of nature and of my fellow citizens can touch all myself, and I bless creation around me.
Thank you, Rosemary. I am going down. Do you think we should read this one about emotions and thoughts?
Yeah, let's do that one. And that's enough to, you know, provide some examples. Observe your thoughts and channel your emotions. Demoralizing thoughts, sad thoughts, come back to invade my mind, and anger takes hold of me. Stop! A wise man told me in Asia that by observing my breathing, the thoughts disappear. That's really all that it takes to meditate. The energy of good channeled anger allows me to clean the windows or cut the wood, which helps me to have clean windows and wood that will keep me warm in winter. Look carefully at your angry face in the mirror and then produce a big smile, a smile that becomes contagious, that multiplies, so that the world around you gives you big smiles.
Great, yes. It's perception, simple.
Simple thoughts that you can experience in your life. So I think we can often make general statements about anything, but mm-hmm. people, but we don't really become compassionate. We don't really feel compassion with the person speaking. As Syed said, we don't become compassionate unless we become aware of their experience. That's the key to compassion, is understand and realize what is the other person experiencing. And that's what we want to share when we write our paragraphs. That's when it really affects the person who's reading it.
Mm. Yes.
So,
yeah,
you know, that I'd really like us all, and I do some of these sometimes too, to focus on how can we bring this down to earth and share a real experience with the people that are reading. And just, you know, make each paragraph a little sharing of a real experience.
I have always been suggesting people to write about something they've lived or someone around them, because the way they will write about it will be different from a descriptive way of writing, because exactly. There should be emotions and real thoughts, deep thoughts, mindfulness. So yes, I join your idea, and I ask and invite the community to write about an experience of yours or an experience of someone around you. It would be wonderful.
Yes. And what I love about Annapis, I mean, I tend to write experiences that are stories, and that's okay. But even better than a story is just a little reminder of something that, you know, is easy to do and how it applies to the idea that I'm trying to share. Mm-hmm. It's really beautiful. Mm-hmm. And it's, you know, it's a good lesson in writing effectively and memorably, because we don't remember what other people said if we don't share feelings from it. That's the only thing we remember is feelings.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can theorize all day, and, you know, unless we took notes and go back and read the notes, we haven't got a clue what the person said. And that's true in reading as well as in listening.
Mm. Yeah.
So it's good practice in effective communication.
Yes. Yeah. So it was very beautiful the way we have been doing it. But if we have to break down this into small ideas for our writers to have a guidance on what to write about. So what can we learn from you, Rosemary, in terms of what are new beginnings? What is new? Sorry.
Well, I certainly think that when you were talking about, okay, when something didn't go well, mm-hmm. a new beginning is you say to yourself, I can do that.
Mm-hmm.
And you start again. That is a new beginning.
Okay.
And I don't know about you, but I have lots of opportunities to start again. You know, to have a day when.
Yes.
Have a day when.
Yes. So if I can, if I allow myself to ask you the same question, Rosemary, as I have been asking others. So in your life, I was saying that even the greatest success or successful people, they might have failed one day or one time. So about your path, your life, Rosemary, did it happen that you failed and you started over and then you succeeded? And what
hundreds of times. Hundreds of times.
Yes.
You know, in little things, certainly. You know, I when I say something and the other person doesn't take it very well, for instance, like, okay, I need to go and tell that person that I'm sorry, you know, that they felt bad about what I said, and I didn't want to say something to hurt them, you know. as a small thing. But, you know, if I've started, you know, some kind of work and it hasn't worked out very well, I'm not really good at that work. You know, it's okay. I generally end up not being able to finish whatever it was. I can think of the first job, one of the first jobs I ever had when I was in my early 20s. I worked for a couple of months. It was in between school and jobs. I worked for my father in an office, trying to straighten out the files that nobody had taken care of. Mm-hmm. And I spent, I guess, 2.5 months doing that. And, you know, then I had to stop and go on to other things. And a couple of years later, I heard him say to somebody about me that I was the worst employee he had ever had. Like, oh my God. okay. I've never worked doing that kind of work after that. And I know that it's not work that I really know how to do very well. So I know I need to find somebody else to do that when I'm in charge of a situation, that it's a job that needs to be done and I can't do it. So, you know, I learned about what I do well and what I'm absolutely awful at. And, you know, I've learned some skills, so I'm not as bad as I was back then necessarily, but that doesn't mean I'm great at tasks that, you know, I'm just not talented with. So I've learned over my life to focus on what I do well.
Yes.
And ask others to help me with what they do well that I don't. And that works. So that's been a learning experience. I cannot do anything all by myself and have it be a great success. I think that's true for many people, but it's a hard lesson to learn.
I think that we it would be good if we can study something like that, because I also deep inside think that I can do everything, but it's not true. But I cannot accept that. I keep trying, and it's consuming me. But after all, I know deep inside that it's not true. I cannot do this. It's not the best thing I'm good at.
Exactly.
Yeah, so we need to focus on what we are good at. That's the sentence. We cannot be good at everything.
Well, most of us aren't good at everything.
That's a good point. In reality, success is not easy.
Right?
Success is not easy. Yeah. One educated person said, when you fell down many times, fail. Please collect your fails and create a bridge. Then fasten this bridge and get success.
Yep.
And also that you mentioned this point, we are not good in every respect of life, yeah? And
that's right.
Yeah. No, I mean, we can be good at different levels, but we cannot be... You see, you cannot be very good at, and we don't need to be like everyone. As my father, was saying, everyone has something. I mean, he is good at something. It's his thing. So we should believe in that. We should believe that. Right. Yes, this is my thing. And I'm good at it, and that's fine.
Exactly. And
most
of us are happiest.
Yes.
Most of what we're doing is stuff we're good at.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not hard to figure out at all.
Yeah. Yeah. And however, I have a more wholeness idea is that as a team, when you are each one good at something, and then as a team, you are good at different things and you are stronger together and you are more productive together and absolutely. You are more successful together. Oh, yes.
Yep, exactly. So that's the whole basic idea of Living Peace Now.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, yes, true.
You know, that's basically what it's all about. And it's rewarding when we're working together and collaborating to make something happen, something that's worthwhile. You know, it's a very satisfying way to spend life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. What I wanted also to mention before ending the meeting is for Abu. Now, Abu, tomorrow, at I guess, this replay will be on the website. All we need to do is to take the link and to post it on all our groups so that people who couldn't or who have missed the meeting can have an idea about what to write about. So when they watch the video. So we are going to do this after each booklet reflection event. We post the link to the video on the groups, and we start collecting the paragraphs 2 days or 3 days after. Because if we wait more than that, people, as long as the idea is fresh in their head, they can write about it. But then they are in different things and they forget. So yep. It's better if we can get the paragraphs as soon as after they have watched the video.
Yes, good idea.
Yes, very good idea. Yes. And you're absolutely right.
I will provide you with the link as soon as I get it, and we start collecting. And just we need to tell people that they are free to send more than one reflection. So, yep. So just they, if I know that it's challenging for someone who likes writing, but keep the focus on one idea. Short paragraph, 150 words maximum. And if you have to say a lot, if you are full of ideas, so break it down in different ideas and write different paragraphs. We accept as many as you can send us.
Thank you so much, Sabrina. That's
thank you.
And we look forward to your thoughts. I mean, it's really fun to read a shared experience.
Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. Thank you everyone for participating and being in the meeting. I look also forward for the second event. I remind, just for a reminder, that the second event is going to be after 2 weeks from now. It means we have 15 days before we meet to share our reflections. I wish I can receive your reflections a couple of days before so that I can put them in a document and I can share it for you to read them the day of the second event. It would be amazing if you can send me this a couple of days before so that I can do my selection. Thank you, yes. Everyone. And Rosemary, do you want to say something and end the meeting beautifully?
Sure. Okay, let's just feel our gratitude, our inner gratitude for this time that we've spent together enjoying being with each other. That's a blessing. And
yeah, thank you for both. Thank you very much.
I am grateful.
I am grateful too. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.